Good evening. Good evening, everyone. My name is Susan Castle, and I am the city clerk for the city of Pickering. Welcome. At this time, I would ask distinguished guests to please rise for the inaugural meeting procession. Thank you. You may now be seated. Welcome to the first meeting of Council of the City of Pickering for the 2022 to 2026 term of office. In accordance with the provisions of the Municipal Act and the Municipal Elections Act, I am pleased to call this meeting to order. At this time, I would like to introduce Marissa Carpino, Chief Administrative Officer for the City of Pickering.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Marissa Carpino and I am the Chief Administrative Officer for the City of Pickering. It is my pleasure to welcome you to the inaugural meeting of Pickering City Council for the term of office 2022 to 2026. This evening marks the beginning of a new term of municipal office for the City of Pickering. The newly elected mayor and members of council will each take their oaths of office in a public commitment to their duties and responsibilities for the next 4 years. We would like to start by acknowledging that the City of Pickering resides on land within the treaty and traditional territory of the Mississaugas of Skugog Island First Nation and Williams Treaties signatories of the Mississauga and Chippewa Nations. Pickering is also home to many Indigenous persons and communities who represent other diverse, distinct, and autonomous Indigenous nations. This acknowledgement reminds us of our responsibilities to our relationships with the First Peoples of Canada and to the ancestral lands on which we learn, share, work, and live. This time, I would like to ask everyone to please stand for our national anthem, sung by Miss Julia Middleton.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see their eyes, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
You can all please be seated. Thank you, Julia, and we'd like to present to you with a token of our appreciation. It is now my pleasure to introduce Pastor Mel Finlay, who will be delivering the invocation. Please join me and stand for the invocation.
Your Worship, Council members, honored guests, all the rest of us who are here this evening, it's my privilege to pray for the proceedings tonight, but also to pray for those who have been elected. Before I do that, I just want to say a couple of words, and that is that for those of you who are newly elected, you've been between in an in-between state between the now and the not yet. The now after you were elected, the not yet before you were sworn in. In a few moments, the not yet becomes the now, and your lives change dramatically. From this point on, your responsibility is not only to those who voted for you, your responsibility is to those within your ward, and more broadly for those of you who are regional councillors, to the people of the region as well. And while your accountability remains to your own ward, you become responsible for all of us who live in the Pickering City of Pickering, surrounding area, and the whole region. And so you're taking on an incredible responsibility that most of us, and probably most of you, are not well equipped to take on. And that's the reason for having the prayer this evening. So I will ask you to be seated, and I will pray for you. O God, creator and sustainer, we pray for your incredible power, for your blessing on those who are presented this evening as incumbents and as those who are newly taking over their responsibilities. For Mayor Cavanash, for Regional Councillor Maureen Brenner, for Regional Councillor Linda Cook, for Regional Councillor David Pickles, for Councillor Lisa Robinson, for Councillor Mara Nagy, for Councillor Shaheen Butt, as they assume their responsibilities for the development, health, well-being, and protection of our city and the region of Durham, region of Durham. We thank them for their willingness to serve on our behalf. May they learn to work together effectively in making decisions that impact all residents. We ask that you give them the wisdom, knowledge, understanding, discernment, courage, patience, endurance, and grace beyond human capability that they will need during their term of office. And Father, we pray particularly that you grant to them the wisdom to know what is right and the courage to do it. In their deliberations, may they give due consideration to many points of view, seek wise counsel as appropriate, and keep in mind the needs of the whole city and of the region. In their decisions, may they act with integrity, without fear or favor or seeking personal gain. In their disagreements, may they not be disagreeable, but strive to reach a position that all of them can live with. And may they and we always remember that we all are stewards of this city and region and all that it offers, with obligations to generations not yet born, as well as to ourselves and to our children. Watch with care over our mayor and councilors and their families in their work, their travel, their family and personal relationships, so that when their service to the city and the region is completed, they and their families will still be healthy and strong. We pray for the staff who serve council. May they be faithful in their service, wise in their advice, knowledgeable and skilled in what they do. And we pray for all of us. May we not be citizens who elect and then neglect our politicians. May we expect as much from ourselves as we do from them. May we be willing to work with them, to walk with them, to pull our weight as citizens of our city and of the region. And may those of us who know the power of prayer pray for them frequently. O God, may your blessing be upon all of us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Finlay. We appreciate your heartfelt words and acknowledgments. Thank you. It is now my honor to welcome Alana Royce on behalf of Jennifer O'Connell, MP for Pickering Uxbridge. Thank you. Peter Bethlenfalvy, MPP for Pickering Uxbridge and Minister of Finance of Ontario, who we expect to arrive this evening. Staff Sergeant Sean Carter, Durham Regional Police. Acting Inspector Kevin Yamada, Durham Regional Police. Thank you for joining us this evening. I'd also like to introduce members of our senior management team. Paul Bajoni, Director Corporate Services and City Solicitor. Kyle Bentley, Director City Development and Chief Building Official. Stan Kurowski, Director Finance and Treasurer. Richard Holburn, Director Engineering Services. Sarah Douglas Murray, Director Community Services. Jennifer Eddy, Director Human Resources. Brian Duffield, Director Operations. Fiaz Jadoon, Director Economic Development and Strategic Projects. Jackie Flowers, CEO of the Pickering Public Library. At this time, I would also like to welcome Dave Whitehouse, President, Canadian Union of Public Employees, Local 129, and Mike Palachik, President of Pickering Firefighters Association. Thank you for joining us this evening. Over the past 27 years of my time at the city, it has been both an honor and a privilege to experience Pickering evolve into one of the most exciting and dynamic cities in all of Ontario. It is clear that the city's progressive journey has been built on a foundation of service. Service of Pickering Council and city staff to the diverse needs of our residents, businesses, stakeholders, and visitors alike. And in this tradition, city staff remain dedicated to carrying out the vision set by this council through the implementation of council-approved policies, plans, and projects. I'm pleased to say that a number of key transformational projects and strategic plans are either underway or ready to be launched. Through these initiatives, as informed by our community and the unique perspective of new and experienced members of council, we can continue to take a bold step in shaping Pickering as a connected, engaged, and innovative city. As I look around the room, It is clear to see the steadfast commitment to community. On behalf of city staff, I reaffirm our commitment to serving the public interest with the highest of integrity and looking forward to supporting the direction of this new term of council through the meaningful services the city provides. There is no doubt, this new term of office marks a unique opportunity at a pivotal point in our history to chart a distinct path forward based on collaboration, consultation, and cooperation between council, staff, residents, and stakeholders. By working together under the leadership of Pickering Council, the city is poised to tackle both the challenges and the opportunities that may lie before us, and most surely will realize our true potential as a city. At this time, I'd like to take a moment to recognize Susan Castle, the city clerk, and the team in the clerk's office for their guidance and hard work during the municipal election. So much is involved by so many staff in order to implement municipal elections in a safe and secure manner. And I would like you to know that your contributions are recognized and appreciated. I would also like to thank Sarah Douglas Murray, the Director of Community Services, and her team of staff who collaborated with administration staff to coordinate this evening's inaugural meeting for Pickering. Thank you once again, distinguished guests, friends, family, and community members for joining us this evening. I will now turn it over to Susan Castle, the city clerk, for the inaugural meeting.
The first declaration of office will be for the office of mayor. I would like to call upon Kevin Ash, elected to the office of mayor, to please come to the podium to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Kevin George Ash, have been elected to the office of mayor in the municipality of the city of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, one, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. Two, I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any other improper manner. Three, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. And fourth, I will be faithful and true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles III. And I make this solemn promise and declaration conscientiously, believing it to be true, and knowing that it has the same force and effect as it made under oath.
Your Worship, you will now be presented with the mayoral robe and chain of office. Please step into the middle of the dais. I would like to call upon Mayor Ash's wife, Karen, their children, Tori, Tyler, Kiara, and granddaughter, Jameson, to come forward and present the robe and chain of office. Thank you. I now declare Kevin Ash as mayor for the city of Pickering for the 2022 to 2026 term of office. Mayor Ash, you may now take your seat on the dais. Maurice Brenner, elected to the position of Regional Councillor Ward 1. Please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Maurice Brenner, having been elected to the office of Regional Councillor, Ward 1, in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, 1, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and my ability. 2, I have not received, nor will I receive, any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any improper manner. 3, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty, King Charles III, and I make this solemn promise and declaration, consciously believing it to be true, knowing it, that is, of the same force and effect as if made under oath.
Councillor Brenner, you may now take your seat on the dais. Linda Cook, elected to the position of Regional Councillor Ward 2. Please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Linda Suzanne Cook, having been elected to the office of Regional Councillor Ward 2 in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, 1, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. 2, I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or other improper manner. 3, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. 4, I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty, King Charles III. And I make this solemn promise and declaration conscientiously, believing it to be true and knowing that it is of the same force and effect as if under oath.
Councillor Cook, you may now take your seat on the dais. Lisa Robinson, elected to the position, sorry, I got ahead of myself. One page back. David Pickles, elected to the position of Regional Counselor Ward 3. Please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, David Pickles, having been elected to the office of Regional Counselor Ward 3 in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any other improper manner. I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles III. And I make the solemn promise and declaration conscientiously, believing that it be true and knowing that it is of the same force and effect as if made under oath.
Councillor Pickles, you may now take your seat on the dais. Lisa Robinson, elected to the position of City Councillor Ward 1. Please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Lisa Robinson, having been elected to the office of City Councillor Ward 1 in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, 1, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. 2, I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any other improper manner. 3, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. And 4, I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles III. And I make this solemn promise and declaration consciously, believing it to be true and knowing that it is of the same force and effect as if made under oath.
Councillor Robinson, you may now take your seat on the dais. Mara Nagy, elected to the position of City Councilor Ward 2. Please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Mara Nagy, having been elected to the office of City Councilor Ward 2 in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, 1, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. 2, I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any other improper manner. 3, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. 4, I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles III. And I make this solemn promise and declaration conscientiously, believing it to be true and knowing that it is of the same force and effect as if made under oath.
Councillor Nagy, you may now take your seat on the dais. Shaheen Butt, elected to the position of City Councillor Ward 3, please come forward to recite and sign your declaration of office.
I, Shaheen Butt, having been elected to the office of City Councillor Ward 3 in the municipality of the City of Pickering, do solemnly promise and declare that, 1, I will truly, faithfully, and impartially exercise this office to the best of my knowledge and ability. 2, I have not received and will not receive any payment or reward or promise thereof for the exercise of this office in a biased, corrupt, or any other improper manner. 3, I will disclose any pecuniary interest, direct or indirect, in accordance with the Municipal Conflict of Interest Act. 4, I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to His Majesty King Charles III. And I make this solemn promise and declare declaration conscientiously, believing it to be true and knowing that it is of the same force and effect as if made under oath.
Councillor Butt, you may now take your seat on the dais. Thank you, Mayor Ash and members of council. I now formally declare you as council for the corporation of the City of Pickering, for the 2022 to 2026 term of office. Mayor Ash, I now turn the balance of the meeting over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Susan, for that proceedings, certainly done in a professional manner, which I expect no less. Before I let my colleagues offer some comments, I do want to acknowledge a couple people that are joining us today. Tom Quinn and his wife Charlie, they are a past city manager and CAO, and my dear friend Joyce Marshall, who is the widow of Noel Marshall, also a past city manager, and welcome back to the chambers today. Each member of council will have a few minutes to offer some remarks, and I first of all I'm going to invite my friend and the longest serving, not continuous, because Councillor Pickles will correct me on that later on, Regional Councillor Maurice Brenner.
Thank you very much, Mayor Ash, and I got it right. I didn't get the name wrong. I guess I want to start off by thanking my family for all the sacrifices that they have had putting up with election after election, meeting after meeting, as far back as 1985. First and foremost, my partner in crime, Ann Bridge. They didn't have a bet on it how long it take me to break down. They have that about Kevin. She stood by me through sickness and health. Unfortunately, in the last number of years, her sickness, but here in health. My daughter, Lindsay, who probably has had the longest reign of putting up with me in politics from the day she was born. My grandson, Carter, who's here for the first time. And of course, who would it be? But of course, Brittany, who has been a driving force in every campaign through her creativity, her photography, and motivation to keep me going when I was tired. Thank you, Brittany. And thank you to my family. You know, my journey started in 1985. And as Kevin pointed out, it may not have been consecutive, but it's an awful lot of a long time, of a lifetime almost, for many of you that are here today. But yet, this council term is by far the most exciting opportunity that I have seen in many, many decades. And I can say decades because I'm decades old. I say that because, and I look to my friend Mayor Ash, and I know that it is a new beginning. A new beginning because we have leadership that is going to be free of bias. Leadership that will not get into the kind of games that we experienced, or some of us did, in other terms of office, or personal ridicule or harassment. I am so proud to have the opportunity to work with you, Mayor Ash. To my new colleagues that have come fresh and new, my city councillor who has my seat, I kept it warm for you from the last election. I knew you'd be coming. And of course, City Ward 2, another new individual bringing great talent and skill and creativity. Regional Ward 2, another ally at Durham Region to be able to ensure we do have a new beginning of a new vision, new opportunities for the people of Pickering and the citizens of Durham Region. And of course, my returning colleagues, Councillor Butt, who we worked many, many long hours in the last term of office. We may not always have agreed, but we always walked away with mutual respect and understanding. On the other end, not the end end, but you're on the left and usually you're on the right. Regional Councillor David Pickles, someone who I saw come to Pickering Council as a young individual, as a city councillor, with more hair then, but still got an okay head of hair now. And again, someone who I've grown to understand, appreciate, and respect, regardless of how votes may turn out. For tonight, I chose a special Bible. And this Bible is the five books of Moses. And it was presented to me on my 13th birthday when I became, as they said, an adult in a bar mitzvah. I picked this book because I feel the rebirth of adulthood. I feel the rebirth of a new beginning, and I feel the new birth of being able to ensure that we deliver the greatest, most possible and creative vision to each and every one of you that are here tonight, regardless of who you voted for, regardless of how you voted. The fact you are why we're here, and I commit to you, and as I do in every new term, I commit to you, the people of Pickering. I will deliver what we talked about. I've heard you, and you can count on my ongoing committed support as we go forward for probably the next most challenging years in the history of this city, but yet the ability to prosper and make a difference. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here, and thank you so much, everyone, for the opportunity to represent you for another 4 years.
Before we go to the next counselor, I want to acknowledge the presence of Counselor-elect Nancy Henry from Town of Ajax, our friends from Town of Ajax. Nancy Henry, first elected and will be sworn in next week. So welcome to our chambers, Nancy. Our next counselor to speak, newly elected regional counselor for Ward 2, Linda Cook. Counselor.
Thank you, Mayor Ash. Wow, this is a big chair when you're sitting up here. So we had some bets on who was gonna cry first. Might be me. It is with a humble heart that I accept this appointment to council. It is a privilege to serve and respect this office. There will be many speeches in the next 4 years, but probably none with as much significance as this one. My being in this chair did not occur without the support of many hands and hearts, and most importantly, through the hard work and dedication of my parents, Curtis and Shirley Cook, who are likely the oldest canvassers this election has ever been graced with at 83 and 80 years old. They are mighty. This is a testament to their belief in me and the values that they instilled in our family. That hard work and community are the cornerstone of who we are and what we are meant to be. I must also acknowledge the dedication and support of my volunteers, Kim, William, Jackie, and Anne Marie, who tirelessly gave their time to knock on doors. Thank you so much. And thank you also to my Special Olympics and Legion 606 families who gave me love and encouragement and so very many hugs when I needed them most. Your belief in me is a powerful thing. To my lovely Joanne, Super J, and her amazing powers of design for making my website a work of art. You are a genius, girl. To my dear friend Bill McLean, even though he's on a beach, thank you for believing in me and encouraging me to pursue this office. Your advice and support have been invaluable. I intend to do you proud and hopefully not break any more office furniture as I settle into your former office. For those who don't know, 5 minutes in my office and I broke a desk. I am that, counselor. And to my beautiful son, Curtis, who continues to amaze me and push me to be better. I love you, buddy. It is your voice I hear encouraging me to advocate for those who can't. I will continue to speak up and to be an ally. My amazing partner, Brian, lift me up. Thank you for all you do for our families. Every day is joy and laughter. I know this office will come with sacrifices for both of us, and I know that you're with me on every step of this journey. And lastly, to the residents of Ward 2 and the residents of the region, thank you for this honor. I will likely make mistakes along the way as I learn how to do this job. I will do it with as much respect and as dignity as I can, and that is my commitment to you. When I fail, I will learn. This is how we grow. I truly love this city and it is a gift to represent our community. Mayor Ash and councillors, I am ready to roll up my sleeves and do this with you. This is a new day and a new council. Let's innovate and invigorate. Let's choose to act wisely and soberly with care for the next seven generations to come. My congratulations to each of you, and it's a pleasure to get to know you better. And now let's get to work.
Our next councillor is celebrating 25 consecutive years on council. My friend, Regional Councillor David Pickles.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Ash. It's an honor. It's both an honor and honorable to serve. And I would like to start by thanking my family, whom I have most of here tonight, my wife and love of over 33 years, my youngest daughter, Allison, and her husband, Cooper. And Allison is expecting our grandchild at any moment, any day. And if you follow me on Facebook, you'll see many pictures of me with their dog, Timber. My oldest daughter couldn't be here this evening. She's a registered nurse at Sick Kids Hospital in Toronto, and you'll know that they're very, very busy, but I know she's thinking of me. And my parents, Jim and Sharon, are here this evening. And collectively, you are always supportive and responsible for all the successes that I have. I also have here this evening my friends and extremely wonderful volunteers, Paul and Karen. I'm glad you were able to join us tonight. I thank you for all the assistance, all the walking, all the steps, all the flyers, all the door knocking, and the heat and the cold and the rain and everything else that came upon us. So thank you all collectively. Congratulations to my colleagues and incumbents on council, Mayor Ash in your new position, Councillor Butt, Councillor Brenner. It's noteworthy that all the incumbents that ran were re-elected, so congratulations. Congratulations to the new members of council, Councillor Nagy, Councillor Robinson, Councillor Cook, of your respective wards elected you to come here and to represent and carry out your duties to the best of your abilities, and I look forward to doing that with you. If I could provide any sort of collective wisdom and advice at this time to all of us, it is always do what you think is right. Let's work together. From the new councillors, I'm sure we're going to hear some new ideas and new perspectives. I look forward to that. From our existing councillors and incumbents, we do bring some experience and knowledge and history along. So I think a combination of all that the seven of us have is going to be very helpful. I would also like to note the extraordinary experience and dedication we have at the City of Pickering here. I'll say Marissa and your team, because I'm not going to name all the people that you named earlier this evening, but they are an incredible team. And new councillors, returning councillors and staff, I think we're going to do a wonderful job. And with the challenges and opportunities we have ahead of us in this term, as I think Councillor Brenner noted, we're not going to always agree, and that's okay. It's okay to agree to disagree, but when you do that on the one vote, you don't carry that over on the next vote. And I hope we can continue the tradition of after council meetings going out and having, I'll say, a cold beverage, and make sure that we're still all on the same page. So, to the residents of Ward 3, a very large thank you. This is my eighth consecutive term. I'm very pleased to have your support and your confidence to represent you once again. I very much look forward to what we're going to be doing collectively together on council. I don't want to shock anybody here this evening, but sometimes social media can be negative. We've been out, we've knocked on thousands of doors, we've talked to hundreds and thousands of residents in Ward 3. And it was very refreshing to see that truth, facts, reason, respect still count. So that was very refreshing. As I say, I think the future holds many opportunities, many challenges. We'll be revisiting the city center plans. We have new businesses coming, it seems like, very regularly to provide jobs and opportunities to our residents. And we'll be entertaining many matters yet about new amenities and new services. And I look very forward to working with all of you on behalf of all of you. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Councillor Pickles. I want to acknowledge the arrival of the Honourable Peter Bethenfalvy, the Minister of Finance, but more importantly, the MPP for Pickering Uxbridge. Welcome, Peter. Now I turn to my right, and here's a lady who has run. She's going to tell me how many times she's run, but it tells you perseverance about keeping at it and getting elected. City Councillor Ward 1, a position I had the honour of filling, position that Councillor Brenner had an honour of filling, and now you have the honour of filling it. Councillor Lisa Robinson.
Thank you, Mayor Ash. Let's see, I ran in the last municipal election, provincial, federal, and again in this one. That's perseverance. That's one good thing that everybody is going to find out about me is that I will never give up the fight. So I just want to say, you know, it is such an honor to be up here today looking out at all of you. It's a real blessing to be here and to be elected as your next Ward 1 City Councillor. And I have all of you to thank. My mom, my son, all of my friends, all the canvassers, all the volunteers, everybody who helped me get here to where I am today, and to you, to the community, and to everyone else who has supported me on this journey, I thank you. So my message is simple. Above all else, the people of Pickering must come first. Too often, elected officials fail time and time again to authentically represent their constituents. That may be their agenda, but it is not mine. Over the past few months, I've laid out a series of firm priorities. Starting today, I will strive to deliver on all my campaign promises and overcome any obstacles that might block our way. Because in the end, I was elected to work for you, and that's exactly what I intend to do. My priority is ensuring that the residents of Pickering are able to prosper in this city. I will always be a strong ally of small and local businesses. I will fight to clean up the city's finances and cut down on any genuinely wasteful spending. My plan to take profits from the Pickering Casino Resort and put that wealth back into the hands of our community is a major step in that right direction. With the rising house prices in mind, I vow to push for reductions in your property taxes and rent so that you can put your money towards your own quality of life. Pickering needs some changes. With winter approaching, one of the first things I will do is push to expand the Pickering snow removal program the best that I can. I might have to wait another year, as we have already discussed, but I will do my best so we can extend that service to each and every resident. In the interest of civic engagement and transparency, I will be hosting monthly town hall meetings, and I'm hoping to do that in Ward 1 here with my fellow council, Maurice Frenner. And everyone, and I mean everyone, will be welcome to attend. Our most vulnerable need desperate help, and I'm entirely committed to tackling homelessness, drug abuse, and mental health crisis. A core philosophy of mine is quality over quantity. I will stand my ground in opposition to the planned high-rise developments along Kingston Road that would interfere with getting families to safety in the event that we ever had to have an evacuation. I will also rein in the endless urban sprawl that threatens our rural land and green spaces, including Rouge Park. I plan to consult with all stakeholders, including the provincial government, to ensure that our community can get the best deals possible in the interest of preserving our natural environment. We need to make what we have work. We need a city that works for its residents, but we also need to work with developers to build a better, sustainable city for all of us for now and for in the future. The last couple of years have brought so many challenges and changes to the lives of all of us. Sadly, this has often led to tensions as we grapple with our own positions on issues instead of working together. We have often made our struggles even harder by allowing division within ourselves. I look forward to being a bridge builder as we turn the page on the past and welcome a new era here in Pickering with our new council. One where we can accomplish great things by tapping into our collective potential and allow everyone to be a part of the successes that lie ahead of us. No matter what, I'm fighting for our community. I love the city and I love you, its people, and I won't let Pickering down. Just as so many kind hearts have had my back over the years, it's only fair that I direct that same compassion back to as many others as possible. So let's stand together and fight for a better Pickering, because above all else, you all come first. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you, Councillor. Our next speaker is newly elected Councillor Mara Nagy. I was most impressed by Mara during the election. Mara is the same age as my two daughters, and I'm not giving away ages, but my two daughters are 30. Mara, so I'm not giving away that secret. So I'm honored to introduce the Ward 2 Regional Council, Mara Nagy. Sorry, Ward 2 City Councilor Mara Nagy.
Thank you. Hello, good evening. Hi, everyone. You've heard from many of us by now, so I want to keep this brief. Whether you voted for me or not, be it choice or ward boundary, I want to reaffirm that I am firm and staunch in my commitment to represent my constituents and the people all across our city. I'm part of a wave of change, and it is truly the most exciting time in a long time to be on this council. It's an absolutely beautiful city here with so much to offer and so much potential, and I count my blessings every single day for not just having grown up here, but now getting to count myself as part of its history. It's not of my own merit, however, that I'm here tonight, and I want to thank my parents, my gorgeous mother and father, Andrew and Andaluza, who made my dream their own. My grandmother, Elena, who can't understand a word I'm saying, but is beaming with pride nonetheless, and my beautiful and perfect partner, Wally, who for truly always believing in me and whose first reaction when I won was, well, of course you did. I also need to thank some dedicated volunteers, in particular Debbie and Martha, without whom half the doors we knocked wouldn't have gotten done, and who turned out for me, blistering heat or rainstorm. Lastly, and without fail, I also want to thank each and every single woman who has come before me in every field, from politics to science, for paving the way for me to stand on their shoulders. It is their sacrifice and their fight that allow me to live the life that I choose and to continue my fight. It is an absolute honor to be here tonight and for the next 4 years. And I thank not just my friends who have turned out from all across the city and across the GTA, but each and every one of you so ardently from the bottom of my heart for being here. Thank you.
Thank you, Counselor. One of the new phenomena is get to figure out your life by Facebook memories. And I had a Facebook memory come up yesterday, which talked about me congratulating Counselor Butt on his appointment 6 years ago after the passing of Rick Johnson. So I'm delighted that Shaheen, who's a passionate voice around this table, has rejoined us. My friend Shaheen Butt, City Councilor Ward 3.
Thank you, Mayor Ash. Always great to work with you, and always looking forward to working with you as well. Good evening, everyone. I'm humbled to be here tonight, given the privilege to serve the residents of Ward 3 once again. I want to thank the residents for their support and placing their trust in me. I want to thank my campaign team, the volunteers. You made it all happen. My best friends. I want to thank my family. You all stood by me. Without your support and encouragement, I would not be here tonight. I get emotional when I talk about my other half, my wife, Ishrath. Whether we're fixing the decks or painting or running the elections, you're always there for your guidance, strength, and encouragement. Thank you. I always get emotional when I talk about my wife. During my campaign, I met many residents and their families, many of whom spoke to me about their concerns with respect to their own personal struggles. And I made notes. You will not be forgotten. I am going to be in touch with you. Yes, challenges lie ahead, but we are living in a city with great potential. Residents are looking towards Pickering to prosper and raise their families. I am proud to be able to contribute to its growth and to the preservation of national assets. This is important to me, and I look forward to working with our new mayor, Mayor Ash, and our new council. I look forward to working with you all to make the city the best place to live in. Thank you all.
Thank you. I think Shaheen might have been the closest to crying, but Councillor Prickles was close. There was a little bit wavering, so I'll try and keep it together. Mayor Ryan always reminded me that the mayor gets the last voice, so this is my first time to get the last word in. So good evening to all my friends, family, and neighbors who have taken time out of their busy schedules to share in this most special occasion. I'm extremely privileged and humbled to be elected as the fifth mayor of Pickering. I pledge to serve this great city with integrity, honor, civility, and humility. And when I describe Pickering as great, I'm not just referring to who we are now, but also where we are destined to be. Pickering, in my opinion, is already Durham's premier municipality, but over the long run, we'll have the potential to become one of Ontario's elite cities. Our collective goal as council is to acknowledge that hidden potential and do everything in our power to fulfill it, because there is nothing more regretful in life than what could have been. And in this case, it won't just be a personal failure, but it will also be letting down all our residents now and our future generations. As mayor, my personal goal is to ensure that we maximize all of our opportunities to grow Pickering in a positive and progressive manner and work towards becoming a more vibrant, engaged, connected, and sustainable city. I have the challenging task of following in the footsteps of the late George Ash, my father, who was the first mayor of Pickering, as well as those of my friend and mentor, Dave Ryan, Pickering's longest serving mayor. While I deeply admire both of these icons, I'll be the first to tell you that I'm not one of them. All those that know me will say that I wear my heart on my sleeve, and those that know me well say it's a big lump of a heart. They will also tell you at times I'm a bit too unfiltered and forthright in my opinions, because I have no reservations in speaking my mind, even if it may ruffle a few feathers. While some may view this trait as a liability, I believe that my openness, honesty, transparency, and accessibility will become the hallmark of my mayoralty. That said, what many don't understand is that the mayor represents but one vote at council. That's why it's critical that this group of seven elected individuals come together so that we can further our shared agenda of investing back in our community and making Pickering the very best it can be. We all come from different backgrounds and have a diverse lived experience, which will make make it truly interesting dynamic. And while it is expected we will have differing positions on matters, we will remain united in our shared passion and commitment to our communities. For this reason alone, I'm confident that we'll have a cohesive and productive council. In fact, when I look around, I see the makings of a great council. For example, Council Pickles has decades of provincial and municipal experience, and his wisdom and insight will play a significant role as we deliberate significant issues. Councillor Brenner is also another veteran of municipal government and is a champion of equity-seeking individuals. He will be dedicated to amplifying those voices. And Councillor Budd is on his third consecutive term, and he brings an unbridled passion and eagerness to serve his community. I have yet to work closely with Councillors Cook, Robinson, and Nagy, but I've had an opportunity to meet with them, and I come away so impressed with their enthusiasm, conviction, and fresh ideas. Although I was first elected in 2003, I think this is the first council where we have achieved near-perfect equilibrium. What I mean is that we have an impressive balance of knowledge and experience, which will be coupled with fresh new ideas and perspectives and how we better engage our residents and govern this great city. This balance will help us move our city forward in a more vibrant and sustainable future, while also permitting us to retain the sense of community, pride, and care what Pickering is renowned for. That said, this is not going to be an easy term of office, because we find ourselves at a crucial junction in our Pickering's history. As such, it is very timely that the City of Pickering will be developing an overreaching strategic plan to develop, define, and lay out our collective vision of our great city. The strategic plan will be a blueprint that maps out how we address and manage the immense pressures, opportunities, and challenges coming our way. As you all are aware, the government of Ontario has mandated that Pickering, along with our GTA neighbors, grow significantly and accelerate housing builds. Ontario has a goal of building 1.5 million homes in the next 5 years, and Pickering must accommodate its share. While increasing the supply will help the issue of affordability, we must ensure that this is a broad and diverse mix of housing options for home buyers looking to own their first house, seniors who are looking to downsize or age in place, and for families looking to establish roots here in Pickering. We also ask the province to give us the tools and the resources to incentivize innovative development that incorporates environmentally sustainable features such as green roofs, solar panels, EV charging, more green space, and highly efficient light and water fixtures. Consequently, it's critical that we do everything in our power to engage our residents in the planning process, so together we can guide and influence that development in order to maintain a high quality of our for all of our residents, both new and old. With all those announcements coming to the province and the resulting media coverage, one term I constantly hear being thrown around is urban sprawl. Sprawl can be described as car-dependent, soulless bedroom communities. That is definitely not what we envision for Pickering. As such, the most effective way to combat sprawl is to bring jobs and economic development to our community. We want our residents to be able to live and work right here in Pickering. By creating more jobs, we can reduce the amount of gridlock congesting our highways, which is better for our environment, and improve quality of life by allowing residents to spend more time with their family and friends instead of sitting in a car. Additionally, by extending the commercial industrial tax base, we can lower the property taxes on our residents and lower the property tax burden. Last year, we introduced the lowest tax increase in 20 years and retained our long-held status of having the lowest property tax rate among Durham's Lakeshore communities. I am fiercely proud of our fiscal excellence, and as mayor, I have every intention to continue to fight for taxpayers. I have a plan for bringing more good-paying local jobs to Pickering through innovation, opportunity, and economic development. Our Innovation Corridor recently hosted the grand opening of Kubota Canada, $80 million corporate headquarters and distribution centers. Earlier this fall, the Premier helped break ground on Smart Center's 233,000 square foot multi-unit complex featuring Lastman's Bad Boy head office. Yes, these are truly exciting developments, but we're not just getting started. We are just getting started. Look for more announcements later this year and early 2023. While housing, jobs, and economic development are important, we need to continue investing back in our community, as I have mentioned earlier. This means prioritizing arts, recreation, culture, which represents the soul of our community. I always believe that civic vitality is intertwined with the arts. It is this shared experience that brings friends and neighbors together, which ultimately strengthens the bonds of our community. We need to build a new performing arts center so that our local artists can finally have a permanent place to call home, so that young residents can explore their creativity, nurture their talents, and just be inspired. A new performing arts center will be a city centerpiece of our much heralded and anticipated landmark city center project. Another key part of this project is the new senior and youth program center, which will provide much needed recreation space and programming right here in our emerging downtown. And as a Raptor fan, I'm proud the city will finally offer indoor basketball space for youth. And to answer that burning question that's on top of the mind of many, the new center will also have pickleball. That's all I heard at the doors: taxes, development, and pickleball. In all seriousness, recreation is key to the livability of our community, and as such, we want to ensure that our recreation fees remain low so that our award-winning facilities, programs, activities, and services continue to be accessible to all our residents. In a similar vein, there is a pressing need to make our city more accessible and inclusive for those with disabilities. We are roughly midway through our five-year accessibility plan. I am proud that we have made significant strides in this area. This year, we unveiled the stunning facility renovations at the Chestnut Hill Development and Recreation Center, featuring a new accessible entry whirlpool, steam, and dry sauna. We also approved funds for the supply of accessibility playgrounds components to retrofit nine playgrounds across the city. Furthermore, we identified four playgrounds that will see full retrofits and upgrades to achieve accessibility for children with disabilities. On that note, I do wish to focus on another disability, one that is non-evident and can be equally as debilitating. The issue of mental health is the utmost importance to me and my family. As many of you know, our son Alex died by suicide in 2018. One would never know that he was suffering because he was funny, smart, and the life of the party. People felt good when they were around Alex, and you would just assume that his positivity he radiated outwards was a reflection of how he felt inside. That sadly was not the case. While his death devastated our family, I can tell you it also brought us closer together and galvanized our resolve, namely to honor Alex's memory. Our mission is to remove the stigma of mental health and suicide. We know that the stigma that surrounds mental health is a huge barrier to seeking help. By being open and honest about how Alex died, and by encouraging people to have those difficult conversations, we hope that those who are struggling feel less alone. I know health and social services fall under the mandate of the region, but as mayor, I will do what I can to educate and engage people on mental health issues. On a larger scale, I want to build a livable city that not only functions well, but also fosters happiness and good mental health. This means building more affordable housing so people can remain in our community at all stages of their life. This means building a vibrant pro-social gathering places like our new city center. This means investing in arts, culture, recreation, so our residents can express themselves, be entertained and inspired, and ultimately be well together. This means securing a hospital for Pickering to look after the healthcare needs of our residents. This means creating jobs in Pickering so our residents don't have to commute to Durham or to Toronto, Markham and Mississauga. And this means investing in our natural heritage, such as our water park, our parks, other green spaces for our children. Admittedly, this is a very long list, and it may seem like a daunting task, but you will be very encouraged to know that we've already made significant progress in most of these areas. We just have to continue to move forward and ensure that we work collaboratively to overcome all obstacles that come our way. And like I said before, I think we have the council to do it. In closing, I want to recognize my family. Without their blessing and support, I would not be here today. My father spent most of his adult life in public service, so I know firsthand the demands of office and the sacrifices that families must make. Despite this knowledge, I still wanted to serve my community. Why? The hours are extremely long. You have less time with your family. The stress is high. The demands and expectations are never ending. You live under a constant microscope. And every 4 years, you have to knock on thousands of doors and ask people to give you the opportunity to continue on. It truly is a thankless job. And to top it off, my wife reminds me that I'll be making less than half I was making in the private sector as mayor. So once again, why am I doing this? My father demonstrated to me that living a life of purpose and duty was a secret to a happy and fulfilling life. And I can't think of a higher duty than serving my community and helping to make it a better place for all. Ultimately, sacrifice is only meaningful when you give up something of value. To me, there is no more valuable than spending time with my family and loved ones. For that reason, my deepest and most heartfelt thanks goes out to my wife, Karen, my children, Tori, Tyler, and Kira, and my granddaughter, Jameson, for allowing me to answer the call. My sacrifice is also your sacrifice. Thank you for your unconditional understanding and support. I love you all, and I promise to make you proud. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I guess I lost the bet. I have we have to move an adjournment motion, but I want to invite everyone to enjoy refreshments, and we'll have opportunity for anyone that wants to take a picture. So with that, a motion to adjourn. Moved by Councillor Robinson, second by Councillor Nagy, that we adjourn this meeting. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Meeting adjourned. Thank you.